Here we go, y'all. Anything can happen right now, y'all.
I love the way it sounds.
Never turn it off.
Give it up for your very own homegrown hero.
And here's your host, Bone Crusher.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We are now live and in the fire with me, your girl, your host, BC. What's up, everybody? I am so excited. In two more days, I'll be the big 4-0. And I represent.
It's my birthday.
I represent for all the Scorpios. It's our season, y'all. What's up?
All right.
Okay, thank y'all. I want to thank all my supporters for your love, your donations, your prayers, and your well wishes. Thank each and every one of y'all. Appreciate it. Okay. Joining me tonight, he's back again to deal with me. You guys know him on Facebook as Mr. Gerald May. Hey, Gerald.
Hello. Hello. Hello, everybody.
Hi. How?
Hi.
What's going on, Gerald?
Nothing much. Just here supporting you.
Thank you. I so appreciate it. Okay, so you know tonight's topic is very sensitive.
Yes, ma'am.
It's so sensitive that it touches home to me. I've extended the invite to this individual to join us tonight, but they respectfully decline, and I understand why. It's a very sensitive subject. So, what are we talking about?
We're talking about sexual abuse as coping with sexual abuse as an adult.
Okay, can you give our listeners a description as to exactly what is sexual abuse?
Yes, sexual abuse refers to any action that pressures or coerces someone to do something sexually they don't want to do. It can refer to behavior that impacts a person's ability to control their sexual activity or the circumstances in which sexual activity occurs, including oral sex, rape, or restricting access to birth control and condoms.
Wow.
It is important to know that just because the victim didn't say no, mm-hmm. doesn't mean that they said yes.
Absolutely.
All right.
When someone does not resist an unwanted sexual advance, it doesn't mean that they consented.
Amen.
Sometimes physically resisting can put a victim at a bigger risk for further physical or sexual abuse.
Mm-hmm.
Some think that if the victim didn't resist, that it doesn't count as abuse. That's not true. It still is. This myth is hurtful because it makes it more difficult for the victims to speak out and more likely that they will blame themselves.
Right.
Whether they were intoxicated or felt pressured, intimidated, or obligated to a certain way, it's never the victim's fault.
All right.
Some examples of sexual abuse or assault are unwanted kissing or touching.
Wow.
Unwanted rough or violent sexual activity, rape or attempted rape, refusing to use condoms or restricting someone's access to birth control, keeping someone from protecting themselves from sexually transmitted infections, sexual contact with someone who is very drunk, drugged, unconscious, or otherwise unable to give a clear and inform yes or no.
Absolutely.
Threatening someone into unwanted sexual activity, repeatedly pressuring someone to have sex or perform sexual acts, or repeatedly using sexual insults towards someone.
Okay, let me ask you, Gerald. Very. And to be honest, I didn't know all these facts until I looked it up. Did you, Gerald?
No, I didn't either. I was shocked at some of that.
I know. I mean, I think we just instantly think of rape.
Right.
You know, saying no and not touching.
Right.
But it goes deeper than that.
Yeah.
Definitely according to what you just read.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you for that description.
You're welcome.
So on tonight's show, we have three brave women. Thank you, ladies, for being here tonight.
You're welcome.
Bravo to you for sharing something that is emotional, sensitive, it has to be very difficult to open up, not only to us in the studio, but to all the listeners that are listening to the show. And I thank you, ladies. Sincerely, I do.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
We're going to start with, I have the pleasure of introducing someone who I grew up with as a child. We live next door to one another. Our moms are friends. And she and I have the same name.
Yeah.
Tanisha. Okay, she goes by the name of Minister Tanisha Hayes. Thank you and welcome for being. Thank you.
Thank you for having me. It used to be, well, I'll say this. I never talked about it.
Okay.
Because of my assailant was so close and dear to me.
Wow.
And so I didn't want to expose them. I didn't know how even to even talk about it. But my behavior throughout my life, I was very promiscuous.
Wow.
And I went from relationship to relationship. And there was really, truly an honesty. In all honesty in my heart, there was no love. I wasn't even looking for the love, but there was an emptiness that I had.
Let me stop and ask you, how old were you?
I was 4 when it first happened. I was 4.
Four. So you have a great memory.
Yeah, definitely. Oh yeah, you can remember, but you remember things like that.
Let's do
you
this.
You really do.
Let's take us back to being 4 years old. Let's talk about that. What happened at 4?
But see, at 4, it being a relative so close and dear to my heart.
Which they are.
When they do it, they do it in love. See, it's not a rape. See, molestation is totally different from a rape.
Okay. Explain
so
to our viewers what's
so,
molestation.
So molestation is more so you coerced.
Okay.
And in your coercion, someone can say to you that, you know, this is nice, or, you know, I'm not going to hurt you, just be comfortable. And if it's someone that you know that you're safe with.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, when you know that you're safe with this person outside of the molestation,
you don't think anything's wrong.
You don't think anything is wrong. You're 4, so your understanding and what you feel, it's like, okay, this is okay. And again, molestation is not forced up on you. And if it's a fondling, and people get it twisted,
okay,
they think fondling is not if you're not penetrated. That's not true. Molestation is if you are touched anywhere inappropriate. It could be your breasts. That's
exactly.
Molestation, that's fondling.
Exactly.
And so it's very uncomfortable. However, it still can cause one to have a certain desire because it's still a pleasure.
Okay, so let me ask you,
okay,
who was the family member that molested you?
Well, that part I'm not going to disclose.
Okay.
I'm not going to disclose that. And I have before, trust me, in the audience of people.
Okay, I respect that.
But I'll
that.
Just reserve that for them. You understand what I'm saying?
I can totally respect that.
But they were
that.
Very close and dear and near, and it was a family member.
Okay.
I will share that much. It wasn't a family friend. It was a family
member. Did you confront this family member?
Oh, definitely.
What
definitely.
Did they say?
And they were like, you know, I was waiting to this time that you would come to me because
seriously?
I want to ask you to please forgive me.
Wow.
But throughout the years, we still had a relationship because, again, it's family. So we still had a relationship, a very close, dear and near relationship.
Wow.
Always. I just never dealt with it because they were still so loving and so kind. Always was.
Did you tell anyone?
And at no, nobody never knew till I was 28.
What made you at 28?
Well, at that time, that's when I got my healing.
Okay.
I couldn't understand my behavior.
Explain to the audience
and
what you mean by healing.
And when I say healing, the healing from the Lord.
Amen.
When I got saved.
Amen.
And the Lord began to deal with me because God called me to this ministry. He called me to the brokenhearted. He called me to those who have been broken in spirit. So therefore, I had to be healed first. I had to be the first partaker
exactly.
of
testimony.
That healing.
Amen.
And he took me all the way back when I was 4.
Wow.
You know, and he said, nah, I need you to see me there. I need you to know that I was there even with you, even in the midst of that, I was there with you.
And I was going to ask you, do you blame God for allowing this to happen?
Oh, absolutely not.
Mm-mm. Great.
Mm-mm. Right. Because I know that the person who did it, I just thought that they loved me.
Really?
I got older, I just thought that, you know, well, maybe some kind of sick, twisted way, something happened. And I just believe that their spirit was exposed to a lot of lust and sexual immorality. Okay. That's all I can believe it was. You understand what I'm saying? When you have men that dibble and dabble in pornography, that dibble and dabble with this woman and that woman, they become sick.
Yes.
They really do.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? And they will use the innocent of a child. Because it's always, a man always wants fresh. Don't get that twisted. Man always wants fresh. If you tell a man you don't have no kids, that man somehow think you Virgin Mary. Nah, bro, I didn't add everybody.
Okay.
And I done killed some babies.
Okay.
That's all the reason why you may know ain't no baby here.
Okay.
Do you understand what
Keeping
I'm saying? But men always want something fresh.
Y'all hear this,
so
fellas?
When you're sick and you perverted, you want fresh. That's why you find men that are perverted, they go after children, because it's an innocent that's being stolen.
Exactly.
So when I got revelation about it, even though it was still someone loving and near and dear, when I got that revelation, I had to still love them, forgive them, and still remain in that relationship.
So how long did it last, from 4 to what age? And did it go further than just touching?
No, because I would be in and out of seeing them here and there.
The contact wasn't frequent. Okay.
And so when I got about 12, they tried it. But by that time...
What you mean tried it?
You know, we tried it again.
Wow.
So I'm like...
Okay, so you're 12 now.
Right, I'm 12 now.
And you're blossoming into a young woman.
I'm doing my thing.
So what... Listen, I am a type of person. I get descriptive. I want details.
Yeah.
And forgive me if it seems
I'm insecure. No, you good.
I want to dig deep, okay?
Right,
so
good.
Let's go here.
So at 12, I'm asleep.
Okay.
And so I began to feel, and I'm like, am I dreaming? And I wake up, I'm like, what's up? And it's like, wow.
If you don't get away from me.
So that night, I just laid there, and I just thought, like, wow. I had no concept, and again... to how it's just like, it's just distorted. Like, this is, and I'm in my life by this turn, this time has just turned at 12. I had a baby at 13, at what I was 14. So it turned. My life just was like this and that, and I just could never understand what was with this behavior. A man couldn't break my heart. Do you understand what I'm saying? So I can go to this relationship, be in that relationship. It didn't matter to me.
Okay.
You know?
So let's
talk
about
that.
I'm
already broken. And so, you know, it could be a great guy.
Okay.
You understand what I'm saying? A good guy. And it's like, you know, I'm like, so when this going to end? When I
really?
Get to a place where I no longer feel good and like I'm not happy. I'm never happy anyway.
Really?
So it's like, what is this? And so I find ways. I'll start stuff. They start any little thing they do. I got to break up with them.
Really?
I was waiting for this to end anyway. You know?
Wow.
And so this happening, this just went on and on and on. And now... now I'm in abusive relationships domestically.
Minister, save that thought. We're going to take a commercial break. You're listening to In the Fire with Bone Crusher. We'll be right back.
Join the club that gives you stuff.
Hey, thanks.
Radio Loyalty.
Here's how it works.
Just click on the Radio Loyalty banner right now and sign up. Then you keep on listening like you already do. But now you earn points. Those points add up, and you can trade them in for stuff in the Radio Loyalty store. Earn more points by sharing your station with friends on Facebook and Twitter, answering surveys, and by using the apps in the New Players App Store. Pretty simple, right?
Radio Loyalty.
Click that banner to join now. We're rewarding you for something you already do, listening to us. It's Radio Loyalty, and it's an easy way for you to get free stuff. All you do is sign up. Go ahead and click the banner now. You'll earn points as you listen, points you can trade in for great products and services in the Radio Loyalty store. You can earn even more points when you share your favorite station with friends on Facebook and Twitter. Radio Loyalty, it's free to sign up, so click the banner to join now.
Hey, we're now back. In the Fire with me, your girl, your host, BC, and I'm joined with my special guest / co-host, Gerald May. What's up, Gerald?
Hey, what's going on now?
All right. We've been talking about sexual abuse, coping with it as an adult, and we've been speaking with Minister Hayes, who said at the age of 4, she was molested by a family member, and she was explaining to us the things that go on as a teenager and as a grown woman. finish your thought, please.
And so my thought on that is that when you get in relationships, well, for me, even though it started out sexually, it began when I got in relationships, it will become domestic, okay?
Physical?
Definitely. Because my behavior,
wow.
I was very aggressive. I was very aggressive.
Was it was from being molested?
Oh, for sure. Because it's a fight. Because, see, what happens is this. Let me tell you something.
Okay.
You have dysfunction.
Okay.
And you have a suppressed anger.
Gotcha.
Not even knowing
why.
That you have anger in you. You don't know that. It's just suppressed.
Wow.
Because that happening, it hurt me, but I didn't know what to do. All I wanted to do was be protected. I just wanted you to protect me.
Okay.
The reason you being in that room with me is because I wanted you to protect me, not to touch me.
Exactly.
So therefore, I became distorted at that moment.
Wow.
So there was an underlying anger. And even as a little kid, my behavior was erratic. I would try to beat somebody and not even know where is this behavior coming from.
Did it start after the molestation?
I believe it did.
Or were you just going to be a bad child anyway?
Could have been.
You know what I'm saying?
It could have been, but let me tell you, that didn't help.
I understand.
You understand what I'm saying? Because it's like what you got to lose now, and you a 4-year-old kid
right.
in that mask,
acting out, right?
You know, acting out. My behavior was just, it was atrocious sometimes.
Okay.
And it was provoking. So.
Okay. Thank you for sharing. We will come back to you. Now, we also have who's going to share her story with us. Miss Sonia. Hi, Sonia.
Hello. How are you?
Fine yourself.
Good.
Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
And thank
you
for sharing your story.
You're welcome.
What exactly is your story?
My molestation happened when I was 4'2".
Darn.
It was a family member.
What?
Yes. It was a family member, a close family member. And, you know, being a child, you really don't understand what's going on. And, like, Tanisha said, it is a pleasure, but it's like you young, so you don't know.
Okay, explain to me what you mean by it's a pleasure.
I mean, it feels good.
If you found them now, how it feels.
If it's by a man that I like, it feels good. But if it's by somebody that I don't, I'm creeped out.
Right.
Get
but
your
you
hands
but
off
you
me.
But you're grown. And so
right.
you can place.
But as a child,
the
you don't.
Exactly.
But as a child,
you don't know.
It feels good.
I felt
good.
Bad for feeling that it felt good. Mm-hmm.
At what age did you realize that?
That.
You felt bad, but it felt good. Because I know at 4, you can't comprehend that.
Probably when I was 40.
40, okay.
To be able to say.
Okay.
It was when I was 40 and I got saved.
So what happened? Let's take me back to being 4. Were you laying in bed? Were you coming home from school? Were you playing? What
in
happened?
Bed. In
sleep?
Bed. Mm-hmm.
You woke up to someone being on you.
Not on
or
me.
Touch you.
Touching me.
Inappropriately.
Touching me.
Oh my
inappropriately.
God.
Right.
Did you spend a night at this person's house?
No, I was
house?
At home. They
wow.
stayed the night at my house. I was at home.
Did you tell anybody?
No.
How long did it
my
go
My mom
on?
Still doesn't know to this day.
Oh.
Yes.
Well, I feel so honored and blessed that she's sharing her story with us tonight.
Yes.
And mommy don't even know.
No.
Huh?
And
is
it
mama
went
tuned
from
in?
No.
Okay.
She's not. It went from that to one of the guys that stayed next door to us.
It moved from the family to
a
neighbor.
A friend. Right.
Wow.
He used to, you know, get us off to school.
Okay.
And I remember the
Getting
first
off,
time.
Right.
Right. He offered me candy. I had to be about 9.
Wow.
Candy. And I remember him taking me to a garage.
Whoa.
Yeah.
On your way to school?
Yes.
Wow.
And, you know, fondling me.
So he never penetrated you?
No.
Is that true?
No.
Okay.
No, he never penetrated
and
me.
And you never told anyone?
No. Not until I got older.
Older.
But like I said, my mom still doesn't know. I told my sisters.
Wow.
But no. But, you know, it does, it steals your innocence.
Yeah.
And it does cause you to be promiscuous because you're still looking for.
I have to, please help me understand. I can't get that. For me, I would think
because
that
you've been,
I don't want you to touch
you've been
me.
Opened up.
You've been open.
I can't.
You've been open to
that.
You've been open,
yeah. open
to a feeling.
Sexual, absolutely.
Yes.
So you want that.
Back at the person that did something. did they act to you.
Right.
You don't see who you're with. You
I cannot comprehend this.
But no, for me, it was different.
Okay.
Like, for her, she said she wasn't looking for love. I was looking for love.
Yeah.
See, when I laid down with a guy, okay. I was looking for love.
Is that because you're a woman, you want love, or is it because you were molested?
It causes different effects, side effects to each person. Because she said it,
promiscuous.
You know, not the promiscuous, but she wasn't looking for love.
Wow.
I was looking for love in relationship, in mine. You know, in my being promiscuous. Yes.
Yes.
And
How does it affect you as a woman?
It changes your whole outlook on who you are, because I had a lot of shame.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know, I withdrew a lot. I had anxiety attacks. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know where that stuff was coming from.
Really?
My first anxiety attack, I thought I was dying. Like, literally, yes.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Have you guys ever had to be medicated?
Yes. No.
No, you learned to control. You was medicated?
I had to be medicated.
But I learned to control mine. When I learned the therapy of the anxiety, then it did. Because I had them young. And so when I had them young, they were medicated with just milk. Just give her warm milk.
Really?
You know, yeah, absolutely. Because the doctors, they didn't ever get off into it, because the one who did it to me took me to the hospital.
Oh,
so I
couldn't
say, oh, well, this is what happened. I'm sorry. This is what happened.
Okay.
And so they're there. I don't want them in trouble.
Exactly.
So I don't say anything.
So you're protecting
them. I'm just enduring. Right. I'm just enduring this. And the warm milk, actually, I'm telling y'all, warm milk does work.
It does
really
work.
Absolutely.
What does it soothe you?
Warm milk. Absolutely. Warm milk puts you to sleep and it relaxes you. Mm-hmm. Yes, it does. Mm-hmm. I had to drink warm milk every night. And I don't know if I just tied my mind and conform my mind to the warm milk and saying, okay, I'm good and I'm calm.
Okay.
But it did work. It really did. It did work. It calmed me and I worked my way through it. Now I can have anxiety attacks, you know, now every now and again. They're very far in between.
Wow.
I have to be, but not about that situation. Okay. It's just that it's something that it get in you. It's like a chemical imbalance sometimes.
Really?
And so it could come time during the times of our woman time.
Mm-hmm.
It could come because you're more up. Everything is elevated in you. And so sometimes it could cause that. And so I have to just keep myself on chill. You know, I have to keep myself on chill a lot.
So it sounds like you have your stuff intact with
the
help of the Lord.
Oh, for sure.
So, Sonya, you're saying that you were looking for love.
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever disclose to the men that you were sexually molested?
Only two. My oldest son's father and my husband.
Wow.
Only to two of them, yes. And
was your relationships kind of like hard in the beginning?
No.
Okay.
No.
So you were able to
because
suppress that.
Because I, not threw myself, but I wanted that relationship, so I went after.
Okay, you made
real
it work.
Hard.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So once I gave myself to someone, then I looked at it, okay, I'm your woman now.
Okay,
you know
like
what I'm saying?
So, women.
Right, but you know, it's like I pursued and pursued, even if they rejected me.
Really?
I still pursued. Because it's like, look, I didn't gave you me.
Really?
So I've given you me.
Wow,
so it's like, no, we go be together.
Really?
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
So, you know, not to cut you off, but you laughing. But aren't you seeing it, though? You like, dang, I wanted some of these women I had.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? And sometimes I think, you know, when I'm dealing with men, I wonder the same thing. I wonder if they were molested.
Yeah.
Because, you know, why do they keep going from woman to woman? You're always cheating and lying.
Right.
And what happened to
those
you?
Spirits.
You know, so we're wondering, you know, were you, you know, did something happen to you as a child? Because why you can't stay in a stable relationship?
Exactly.
I know why I couldn't.
Okay.
You know, not trying to figure out, dude, why you couldn't somebody touch you?
Right.
That's what's happening.
And you know, not too many of them are going to admit that.
They're
not.
Not
at all.
Absolutely
not at all.
They because they be full of shame.
Right.
You know.
So
that's a man. Yeah.
And it causes you to put a mask on.
Right.
On you know on who you are because. You really don't understand. It's like, why am I doing this? Why, you know, why do I have these feelings? Why do I go after
certain
you know,
type of men
so hard?
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But you've been opened up, and it has different effects. You I'm know, just, it causes oh you gosh. To live differently.
Yeah. Such
you know,
as?
I was more withdrawn. But okay. when a man showed me interest,
okay.
then I went after him.
Okay. Were you too know? Clingy? Hard. Were you too clingy? Can you
very
say,
clingy.
Really?
Very clingy.
Is it because, okay, forgive me for my
because
ignorance.
You, but you don't want
I'm
that.
Trying to
you
understand.
Want, no, right. I, you don't right. know. You want that attention. You want that affection. You know what I'm saying?
You need you that
want,
whole feel.
Right.
You really? Got a hole in you. You got a hole from yeah. your innocence being taken, and you need a feel.
Yeah.
And you think and it, I can't, it, and ooh. You're trying to place it with a man that's going to do good.
Right.
You and I'm trying
I
to understand
protection.
You, ladies,
I wanted somebody to protect me.
From the... From I've what I can kind of.
I've had a few men tell me I was needy in sex three.
Okay, yeah. we're going to talk to you in 1 second, yeah. Ms. Yeah. Tracy. Yeah. Because I'm just trying to process this all for me, mm-hmm. not being in your guys' shoes.
Oh, no.
My understanding says to me, if I'm sexually violated, I think I mean, I'm processing this because I've mm-hmm. never been in a situation.
Mm-hmm.
I would say, I don't want to be bothered with men, period. I mean,
it,
because I felt
depending on the situation.
When you've been molested, it's gonna go two ways.
You either you're like
gonna,
me, go after them,
go
yep.
after the man,
or you're gonna be gay.
You're seeing your
huh?
Yeah, yeah. You'll go gay.
Too.
A lot of women went gay when they got raped.
What?
A lot of women, absolutely. Absolutely.
Even huh? by man.
If the rape was by
even
man.
Even if a rape, definitely.
Yes.
They'll
really?
Because
you tie that to that man.
They
you
begin
know,
to protect
man.
Themselves.
So it's yeah. all about a certain type of feeling. Because
you're,
we women,
absolutely.
We like feeling. We're emotion driven. So wherever you get that right. from is mm-hmm. what you attach yourself
yeah.
to. Is that what you're saying? Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some women, they've been raped. And they went the other way. They go with women. They don't deal with men, period.
Because
they don't,
of
because they were raped. They were, they couldn't deal with that. It was like a form of control.
Wow.
See, a rape is different. You know,
okay.
a rape is like power
let's,
and control.
Let's pause you right there and
you
let's
know.
Talk to a rape victim
yeah.
in a, on the show tonight. What's up, Red Snapper?
Hey, hello, everybody.
Okay, I see your leg twitching and you shaking. Are you able to go through
yes,
with this?
I'm good.
Yeah, okay, we're going to need good. You to speak up. Okay, so we've talked to Minister Hayes and Miss Sonia, and they've both been sexually molested.
Yes.
What's your story?
I was raped at 16 by a guy I was dating.
Wow.
And he blamed me for being beautiful.
Mm. Wow.
And...
What do you mean? Okay, help me understand. What do you mean by that?
Well, we were supposed to be going out, and he turned going out into a hole. He went from Dr. Jekyll to Mr. Hyde,
mm.
and the doors locked, literally, and he
wow.
just went to... All you women ain't shit. Y'all bitches, y'all hoes, mm-hmm. y'all, you think you beautiful. I mean,
okay.
just dog
wow.
me. And every time he did it, I caught a blow to the face.
Wow.
Wow.
And he ended up taking me to a hotel. And
okay.
he pulled me out the car. Every time he pulled me out the car, he would pull patches of my hair.
Oh, mm-hmm. no.
And he took, when he took me
That's
in his
okay.
room.
Wow.
Where did you meet this guy?
At school.
Mm-hmm.
So this is somebody you felt like you can trust?
Well, you know, he came, you know, I'm not going to mm-hmm. lie, in school, you know, I mm-hmm. liked older guys.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
mm-hmm.
he pulled up on the side of me.
Mm-hmm.
And
so back then you
numbers.
Was into them cars
yeah.
and them sounds
yes,
and the
I
rims
was.
And all
I
that
was.
Good
I
stuff.
I was a hot girl.
Okay.
I'll say that.
He was a hot ass.
And
okay.
and he chose to use that time that against me
yeah.
and
wow.
call me mm-hmm. everything but the son of God.
Wow.
And throughout the time that he raped me with numerous objects.
Mm.
Wow.
Wow.
So
wow.
So
he took
wow.
you to a hotel.
Yes.
You got he drug you out by your hair.
Yeah.
Threw you into the room. And
he did whatever he wanted to do to me.
And you wow. felt powerless.
I was powerless.
Did
I
you try to fight back? Or were you scared?
I was cuffed.
Wait a minute, hold on. He handcuffed you?
He handcuffed.
So he walking around or he driving around with some handcuffs?
Well, he's not driving around anymore.
Or y'all having sex with some handcuffs? Or
I never had even had sex with
Oh,
him.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. We were just getting to know each other.
Mm-hmm. Wait a minute.
That's
why
that was the first thought. That was that's all I've been saying in my head. I said, that's a predator.
Wow.
In my head. I'm like, that's a predator.
It was the first date. And he used that against
first date.
Yes. And he raped me for hours. I don't know how long it was, but
wow.
I can say that I blanked out my body. I had to, and because I couldn't handle it.
Wow.
Wait, you did what? I'm sorry.
She blanked out of her
body. Blanked out.
She,
yeah.
I had to.
You do that.
I had to blank out.
Yeah. You can do that.
And it was.
Yeah.
And the worst thing was, unfortunately.
And you went to high school with this dude?
No.
No, she said he was older.
I met him when I was at high school.
Okay.
He was driving by. He was grown.
Okay.
And he raped me for hours. He beat me.
Did you try to scream or anything, or you were too scared to do anything?
You know, it's, I did, but no one was listening. Mm-hmm. Because when he drugged me out of the car to the hotel room, people could see, but no one said anything.
Wow. Mm.
Let's pause for a second. We need to take a commercial break, and you guys are still in the fire with me, Bone Crusher. We'll be right back.
It's the all-new Hollywood Bamboo, located at 26488 Grand River Avenue, Redford, Michigan. Go over there and tell my girl Takesha I said take care of you. Shoes. Accessories. Dresses. Hollywood Bamboo. Skirts, blouses, whatever you may need, bad girls, get it at Hollywood's Fab Boutique. She's such a bad girl, crazy. That one of a kind outfit, those one of a kind shoes. Why go to the mall when you can go to Hollywood Fab Boutique? VentRadio.net is sponsored by Hollywood's Fab Boutique. Now, well,
found someone to ease my pain and hold on.
And here's your host, Bone Crusher.
We are now back and live and in the fire with me, your girl, your host, Bone Crusher. Gerald May, what have we been talking about today? It's been very, very touchy up in here.
Absolutely. We've been talking about sexual abuse, coping with it as an adult.
Right.
Very interesting stories here.
Very. Three brave women are with us tonight.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's a blessing that you guys are, like I said, once again, are sharing your stories. Some of you for the first time, some people don't know, but you have brought your stories and your testimonies here, and I thank you guys so much, and I appreciate it. Sincerely, I do.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you guys for being here.
Appreciate the opportunity.
Let's continue with Red Snapper. You ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Okay, now you were saying that the guy that raped you was older. You were 16?
I was 16.
And he was? 20, he was about 20, 21?
Mm-hmm.
Took you to a hotel. Mm-hmm. What? Had you in a car.
Mm-hmm.
Drug you out by your hair.
Mm-hmm.
Took you to a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
Raped you repeatedly for hours.
With numerous objects.
Let's talk about some of those objects, if you don't mind. Like what?
The objects that I remember, the handle of the barrel of a gun.
Huh? Mm-hmm. He jammed it up in you?
Yeah. And I remember a broom handle.
A broom handle? Wait a minute. Okay, you guys are in a hotel. Yeah. Where the heck does he get a broom handle from?
I found out later he was living in that hotel.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Wow. So how did you get free? What happened?
He took me and dumped me.
Wait, hold on. You in a hotel. He's raped you with numerous objects.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Are you dressed when you guys leave?
That part I really don't remember.
You blacked out.
I blanked out. Mm-hmm.
You just noticed that when you came to, you were where at?
In a wooded area.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Thank God he didn't. Did he? Okay. Did he beat you up bad?
Beat me up bad.
Mm-hmm.
He beat me up bad.
Did he try to kill you? You think?
Yeah. He wanted to kill me. He was choking me.
Wow.
And it wasn't my time to go.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
All I can remember was my mother's face. And I said, I can't leave my mother.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Amen. Did you have any kids at this time?
No, I didn't. But the sad thing is, it was a week after I had an abortion.
Wow.
So I was still open.
Open, yeah.
Oh, no.
And it ended up giving me a collapsed uterus.
Wow.
Yeah,
Lord
have mercy. Mm-hmm. And they told me one day it would turn into cancer.
Wow.
So when I was pregnant with my son.
What age were you when you got pregnant?
18.
Wow.
And they told me it could go that we both could die.
Wow.
Or he can die. And I at least wanted to say I birthed one kid.
Okay.
And when I was in labor, it was very hard. I was on bed rest and everything.
Yeah.
Wow.
And he's a blessing because after that happened, I became promiscuous.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Wow.
All I could see was the person that did it to me.
Let me ask you before you go into that. This is someone who you really didn't know.
No.
So you weren't able to, did you go to the police?
Went to the police and basically they treated me like I wasn't shit.
In Detroit.
And they let the guy go.
Wow.
Wait a minute. So you were able to identify him to the police and they did pick him up and apprehended him.
Yeah. They said they didn't have anything on him and let him go.
Did you go to the hospital and get it like a rape kit or something?
I was in the hospital.
Really?
She had been beaten.
Wow. I am like in a loss for words. I'm I'm trying to understand that. Wow.
It affected the way I look at men.
Yeah, definitely.
It affected the way I live. Mm-hmm. It affected the way I trust men.
Ooh.
I can understand.
It affected the way I raise my son.
You have trust issues now?
I'm coming out of them.
Okay.
I can say that. Mm-hmm. And that's because my heart won't allow me to hate a person.
Have you forgiven him, though?
I have forgiven him.
Okay.
I'm glad that I don't have to ever see him again.
Have you ever saw him since this? Could you identify him to this day?
I don't have to ever see him again.
Okay, I can read between the lines on that. Okay.
But the worst thing that hurt me was when I called my dad to tell him.
Mm-hmm.
He told me it was my fault.
This is your own father.
My own father.
The man that birthed you told you that it was your fault.
It was my fault.
Why would he say something like that to you?
My father was always on and out of drugs. Okay. And that was one of his moments. And so I had a lot to deal with, and I dealt with it alone. Mm-hmm. I tried to commit suicide.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
How many times?
Just once.
What did you try to do to commit suicide? Did you put a gun to your head?
I tried to slit my wrist.
Whoa. Did you?
No.
What made you stop?
Because I have a strong spiritual backing.
Okay.
I know that if you kill yourself, you're going straight to hell.
Nah, tell the truth.
Wow.
And that has kept me grounded.
Amen.
Okay.
As always. And I can say, I understand why I had a son at a young age.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Because if I didn't, mm-hmm. I would probably be strung out.
Mm-hmm. On drugs? Mm-hmm. Prostituting?
Both.
Mm-hmm. Really? Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Prostituting?
Whatever.
Whatever.
Whatever you gonna do.
I was a teenage mom, too. And I wanted...
This is Sonya speaking, guys.
A child for the love. You know what I'm saying? To someone to love me mm-hmm. unconditionally, and someone that I love mm-hmm. unconditionally. I have three sons.
Okay.
And it does affect the way that you raise them. I wouldn't let them go anywhere.
Mm-hmm. I know. You know. Very protective.
Didn't want them out of my sight. You know, they could have their friends over, but no, you cannot go to anyone's house.
Yep. Now, with sons, did you always check just to make sure whomever is watching your sons? Because boys, you know, we treat them a little different mm-hmm. from girls.
Always.
But did you always check to say, hey, is anybody touching you?
I did.
Don't be scared to tell them. You did?
I did.
What about you, Minister Hayes? You made sure no one was touching? Okay.
Yeah. You'll just be conscious. You won't let them go nowhere. You mm-hmm.
overprotective.
Overprotective. Mm-hmm. And if you hear any little thing, my daughter say my cousin humped on her.
Wow.
And they like... You know, handling me like, you know, because they don't know which way, what bag I'm going to come out of. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying? And so, you have a lot going on in your life. You really do. You have a lot going on in your life, you know, emotionally, you know, and spiritually too.
You have a lot going on.
Yes, you do.
If you like to call in, share your story, you have a comment, you have a question for these ladies, call us in. What's that number, Gerald?
248-429-7224. Come on and call in.
So back to you, Snapper. Promiscuous. I know I've heard Minister Hayes and Miss Sonya's story. Explain to me, how does one become promiscuous after being raped? The way that you've been raped.
You no longer see a man as a man. You see the face of your accuser.
Do you really?
Yes. Yes.
Wow. Wait a minute. Okay, so if you're having sex with another guy, you're automatically looking at the person that took your innocence away from you. So what do you do? Okay, you're having sex with a guy and you're looking at your rape person.
It makes you aggressive.
Yes, and it makes you try to gain you're just trying to gain your power back.
That's what it is.
So what do you, I mean, okay, mm-hmm. excuse me for being ignorant, but are you sexing them harder or?
Yeah, absolutely.
Really?
You can.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Really? I know for me, I was in a trance. Like that, but for me, it's different. But for rape victims, definitely. They're trying to get back their control.
For me,
they're
I was
trying
in
to
a
get
trance.
Back that power. Yeah.
You were in a trance?
I was in a trance.
What do you mean by a trance?
Just like I drifted out of my body when he was doing that to me. I've drifted then.
So when you have sex with men, you
not anymore,
out of body.
Back then, when I was trying to find that love, because it made me try to find love in a man. And also
really?
Because my father didn't have my back.
Rejected
you. That was the hardest rejection. Mm-hmm. I never got any help because my mom came from an old school family, which is scrub their body and give them a Valium and it'll
really?
Be over.
Really? So did you tell mom?
Yes, and still to this day, my mom won't speak about it. But
really?
I
understand.
Yeah, it'd be too hard. Sometimes they can't deal with that.
And it happened to you guys, and the parents are the ones that's taking
well,
it
you
hard.
Know, back then... And especially in people of color.
Okay.
There's the old, what goes on in our house stays in our house.
Oh, wow.
You know, so I didn't tell, you okay. know, but there were, you know, family members that have been molested. My mom saw her cousin.
Sonya, 1 second. We have a call. Caller, you are in the fire. Go ahead. Hello?
Hello?
Caller, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Can you speak up? Who am I speaking with?
Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I could barely hear you. Yeah, this is Al Bone Crusher. How you doing?
Find yourself. I can't hardly hear you. 1 second.
Yep.
I can't hear him good.
I can't hear him. I can't.
We can hear him.
I'm sorry. Who am I speaking with?
I said this is Al, your co-worker.
Hey, Al. How are you?
I'm good. I just wanted to let you know that I was listening to your show. And just had a quick little comment. I really, my heart goes out to the three women in the studio with you tonight. And this topic that you're discussing just happens to be ironic with something that went on a little earlier today. A hypothetical question was asked, if you could get a free pass at crime, what would you do?
Okay.
You know, a lot of times... I'll not necessarily consider some of my words when attempting humor. So rather than say the typical answers that everyone gave, you know, everyone pretty much picked rob this and rob that.
We know you're a little different.
So I put rape, rob, and murder, just three little words, you know, and then let it go from there.
Okay.
Took a little flack over that.
Okay.
And, kind of understand the flack now more than I did at the time, and so for anybody who might be listening to your show, who may know anything about that, I'm gonna apologize to every woman that could be listening for just even hypothetically joking like that, because at the time, you know, when we attempt humor, we don't necessarily always consider the repercussions and how it could affect someone else. When you know, just basically trying to be funny, you know.
Right, exactly.
And so, you know, just the fact that, you know, of course, I'm trying to listen to your show, support you, you know, you and my friend.
Oh, thank you.
And this is the topic that you happen to have. I felt compelled to at least call in and, like I say, offer my condolences to the women and any other women who could have been a victim of,
sexual
such a
abuse.
Heinous crime.
Right.
Yeah, in both instances, the molestation that came from, you know, being manipulated as a child, you know, I think that's terrible. And to the other woman who, you know, that was really terrible to happen to her.
Right.
And so, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank
so, you know,
Al.
But that's pretty much why I called, you know, to participate in the show.
Thank
you. You know,
you
got my support. And for anybody else who could be listening that was a part of that, you know, earlier today, you know, I mean, I understand more now than I did ever.
Exactly.
And I think all things happen for a reason.
Amen.
I didn't know what your topic was. I didn't know what your topic was going to be.
Mm-hmm.
And then at the time, I didn't have to get that answer either in trying to be funny. So
exactly.
It all came out to be like this for that reason, and that's why I'm calling.
Thank you so much, Al.
Well, we receive your condolences and your apology.
Yes,
and brother,
you
be blessed. You be really blessed. And thank you again.
Thank you, Al.
Okay. All right, now.
I'll see you tomorrow.
All right.
I'll see you later.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, so for Minister Hayes, you have children.
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about abuse. How does that play into a factor when you have been sexually molested? You say that you have problems with men. Are they physical with you, or are you physical with them? Are they verbally or physically?
It went both ways. You know, the abuse started when I was like 13. I had a boyfriend.
Fast butt.
right.
Let me tell Val.
Inappropriate, wrong age, and all that. And he was, you know, we were in a domestic violence
at 13
relation. Oh yeah, but girl. But again, like I said, these men came from being abused by their parents. You know, they come from being abused by their parents. And so, or they watch their mother, you know, but just to find out about him being the first one, well, his mother was abusive to him. And it looked like to me that he just couldn't stand women. You know, uh-huh. He couldn't stand the if you feel like, or if you, he always would try to demean me. He always would try to demean me. Okay. You know, if my hair is a certain way and this, and years later, when I ran into him years later, he still kind of had that demeanor. Mm-hmm. But I had to let him know, you got to back down, because okay. I'm not her.
Okay.
And so we can't be anything. We can't be anything. We can't be friends. We can't be anything, because I see all of that on you, and I am okay. So not who that is today.
Okay. Exactly.
And so you
strong
can
woman.
See you can see that behavior, and I back a brother down right quick. I know I can be assertive. I can be very assertive. I'll be very transparent and very clear.
It must be a Tanisha thing.
Some people can't handle that. Some men can't handle that. They can take that as you being aggressive. No,
true.
I'm being assertive.
Assertive.
I'm being
exactly.
direct with
exactly.
you. And I'm being straight up with you. Now, I understand yep. you might can't handle that.
Okay.
And that's okay. But let me tell you what I can't handle.
Okay.
I can't handle you if you feel like you in a fight, because you're not in one.
Okay.
And so when I see it, I back down and I'm good.
Exactly.
You go right ahead, and some other sisters can handle it. And I hope I can get to them before you get to
okay.
them, and let them know he ain't the one.
There you
right.
go.
You know, if somebody can easily, you need to be healed too, brother.
Okay.
You need to be healed too. I know your mama might have beat you, your daddy might have beat your mother, but you got to get healed too. Just like I come from it,
right?
You came from it. We got to be healed, because
I don't
see
know
now
if
we
men
can't.
Are willing to talk about that though.
Some, well, you know what? I got one brother that I can truly say that
okay.
a brother that he goes along with me with the domestic violence.
Okay.
And again, he's the producer over at, you know, at the radio station that we broadcast
okay.
at. And so, you know, he did. He would beat women. He
wow.
abused women and everything, but his mother beat him.
Yeah. Really? It's
his
a
mother
cycle.
Beat, he said, and I hated my mother. I hated her. He said, when I see men jump on my mother, he said, I would be like, yeah, hit her again.
Wow.
Because she would beat him.
Right. So he was
you
like
know?
Payback.
And so it was like payback. So he would go and abuse women.
Wow.
You know, and so I'm telling you, when you see people's behavior, they be sick.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I'm a counselor now from that. Now I can go
okay,
and counsel
good.
Some folks
exactly.
because now I'm healed.
You're healed, right.
You understand what I'm saying?
And
so when people go to talking that stuff to me, I be like, you.
Hold on now.
You need some help.
You need Jesus.
You hurt it.
Right.
Hurt people.
Right.
But when you get tired, you deal with it for years. Mm-hmm. And once you become older and you get sick and tired of being sick and tired,
okay,
and you learn your worth as a woman,
mm-hmm.
that is when you make your change.
Absolutely.
That is when you completely open up. You can hear God's voice. I can truly say I relived my rape again mentally about 5 years ago.
Wow.
But to relive that, and I'll never forget, I was with my friends at a Tyler Perry movie for Color Girls Only.
Mm-hmm.
And to rock that rape scene, they had to take me out of there.
Yeah,
wow.
I had to do it in order to free myself.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Because it was like being trapped in a bottle and you can't get out, and you just spinning and you spinning and you spinning and you just repeating things.
Okay, let me ask you ladies this right quick. Have you ladies seen the movie Addicted, and can you relate to that?
Definitely.
Can you?
I was sitting there just giving a whole, I say, listen, I
did
too. I feel like I'm in a session. Because they look
yeah,
like.
Yeah, she talked through the whole movie.
Because people think that, because again, like I said, I told them, I say, see this one, this is a two-way street.
Okay.
This is a two-way street. You get with men, they are the same way. Mm-hmm. They've been affected some kind of way or another. It could have been a woman that molested them, mm-hmm. or it could have been a man.
Exactly.
Who knows? Women molest girls too.
True.
Okay. Yeah. So it could go both ways. It's a straight running street, both okay. ways, right? Okay. Mm-hmm. And so a man, when you see men with that type of behavior, women just think, oh, he just low down, he just dirty, he just is gigolo, this and that. No, he's sick.
Okay.
He's sick.
Some may disagree with you, but I'm with you. Right.
I'm definitely.
Gerald,
what
you think about that? Are men sick, Gerald? What do you think about Minister Hayes' comment about that?
Some.
Yeah.
Oh, just like that. Just some.
Yeah,
huh?
Very
simple. Of course, he's not going
right
on his.
You got some brothers that know how to be faithful. You know some brothers that know how to be.
Where y'all at? Call in right now. Where the faithful brothers at?
So do you ask the brethren? But now watch this. If your brother cheat. And you ask them, so why did you cheat?
Mm-hmm.
And then what be the answer? Well, you know.
I'm a man.
You know, I mean, I just go out and do that. Well, then what makes you do that? Because, see, I need to know what makes you do that.
Do what you do.
You know, what makes you cheat? You know, what makes you go after?
That's another show.
Right. Okay, and on that note, guys, we need to take another break. And you're live and in the fire with Bone Crusher. We'll be right back.
Co-host Gerald May, and today's topic is coping with sexual abuse as an adult.
Mm-hmm.
We've had three strong women in the
brave women. Very brave. Thank you guys for being here. Yes.
Thank you for having us.
With us, and we appreciate everything that you guys brought today.
And we just want to say that I am touched by each and every one of you guys' story individually and collectively. I don't know about you, Gerald, but I did learn some stuff, and I'm still baffled. I'm not going to say that I fully understand everything, mm-hmm. but I do thank you ladies for sharing your stories. And real quick, how do you get help for this? Or is it always an open wound? I'll go to you real quick, Minister Hayes.
Well, it's definitely help. I got help.
Okay.
And I had to get spiritual help first.
Amen.
Because that's where everything, that's where life comes
that's
from.
Where life
comes from out of your spirit.
Okay.
So I had to get spiritual help. And so me getting the spiritual help, because see, that gives you truth.
Okay.
You see yes, what I'm saying? Does. I don't need nobody to cover up my foolishness. Yeah. Oh, you understand man. What Amen. I'm saying? Don't tell right. me that, you know, you feed me apples and you really giving me oranges. Don't do that to okay. me. Right. Just tell me straight up it is what it is.
It is.
Okay. You know what I'm saying? And so you have to get that spiritual help, because now you got to get in tune with mm-hmm. your spiritual life.
That's
because
right.
what has happened, your natural life has been damaged.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So when you get in touch with your spiritual life, you get healed inside.
Outside. Okay.
And so that's my suggestion. And me as a counselor, I like to do that with the women. Women that, you know, if we have listeners and they're struggling and they don't know where to go from here, what to do, how to do it, then
they
by all means,
see you.
They can come and talk to me and uh-huh. I can help you.
All right.
But you got to be willing to help yourself.
Amen. That's the first step.
And be real with yourself.
Sister Sonia, what are your last words? What do you have to say to the people that may be listening or dealing with some of the things that you guys have dealt with? What are your words of encouragement?
My words of encouragement would be first to be honest with yourself.
Okay.
You know when there's something wrong inside of you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what's going on the inside comes out. It's gonna, your actions are eventually going to come out of what you're feeling on the inside. So I would suggest getting some type of counseling.
Okay.
You know, or just letting someone else know, because I held it in for many, many years.
Mm-hmm.
People didn't know,
mm-hmm.
you know, they saw the outside part, but didn't know what was going on in the inside.
Okay. So you encouraged to get some type of,
right.
help to support
let
groups.
Somebody
okay.
know,
okay.
you know, mm-hmm. cause keeping it bottled up, you are
suppressing,
raging.
Yes.
You're raging mm-hmm. on. Mm-hmm. It's like a Tasmanian devil.
Okay. Yep.
Because you can suppress it and, oh no, this. And then that one thing that happens mm-hmm. and it causes all of that to come out.
Mm-hmm. And then you can actually saying? Take that out on someone who's totally innocent
yeah,
of
absolutely.
What you're dealing
yeah,
with.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Oh, right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay. Red Snapper, what are your final thoughts? What are your words of encouragement? What do you have to say to the people who may be listening, who have experienced some of the things that you've experienced?
I say, trust yourself, listen to yourself, express yourself. The more you talk about it, the better you can cope.
Mm-hmm.
Letting
mm-hmm.
people know is not a weakness, it's actually a strength.
Yeah, and it's right. not your fault.
It's not your fault. You never right. know who you can touch mm-hmm. or who you can say something to that may make them feel better. You don't
that's
know
right.
what they're going through before they've seen
right.
you. So I tell people, when I smile from so many different directions.
Okay. Wow.
But my smile is a heavenly smile, because uh-huh. I'm still here.
Amen.
And I'm
Amen.
Meant to
Amen.
Be here.
Amen.
And I'm learning now what my purpose is on life,
wow.
and it's to help other women.
All
Amen.
Right.
Awesome.
And keep going,
Amen.
Girlfriend.
Awesome.
Thank you, ladies, for being here once again. Thank you, listeners. Hopefully these
you.
Ladies touched you and you've learned something. And until next week, you're in the fire with your girl Bone Crusher. Don't forget, November 4th, go out and vote.
That's
Scorpio
right.
rule, baby.
That's my birthday.
I gotta get it in.
That's my birthday.